Dr. Chetan, for you, we would like to know, we've heard a lot about umbilical stem cell banking, you know, that's a lot that's been going around for a longer time, much longer than we even heard about dental stem cell banking. So how is dental stem cell different, and when do you think parents can start thinking about banking dental stem cells?
Like we all know, the umbilical cord banking has been like in the face since almost 15-20 years, or maybe more than that. But this is very prevalent in the foreign countries, like you can consider US, UK and the other countries. But the awareness about especially the stem cell banking itself, it's not there in India. And the dental pulp stem cell banking, it's a very new concept. Though it is prevalent in other countries, it is not very prevalent here.
Yes.
Because that is the main reason behind that is the lack of awareness among the parents. And the right age for stem cell banking, especially when we consider dental pulp stem cell banking, we consider it as between 5 to 11 years of age. Mm-hmm. And that is the age when the deciduous teeth, what we call the milk teeth, they start falling. And in dental stem cell banking, we consider dental pulp stem cell banking, it is very less invasive. In umbilical cord banking, we have to collect the cord tissue, the umbilical cord, and as well as the cord blood. Which is actually not very sterile when you compare to that. And the tooth, inside the tooth, we collect the pulp. The pulp is exposed when we come into dental stem cell banking. The pulp is exposed only in the environment of the lab, which is very sterile and not at all contaminated. You can say it is highly resistant to contamination. Since the pulp is exposed only in the lab, we get the quality of stem cells, what we get there is highly, highly, highly good. So, and when we consider the age of the tooth, like between 5 to 11 years, we have a teeth from incisors to the last molar of the baby. And the early falling tooth are considered to be the rich sources of the stem cells. And since the tooth is the last organ to be developed in the body, it definitely has highly potent mesenchymal stem cells, what we call, and that have two major features which of the stem cells. One is multilineage differentiation and second is self-proliferation. The self-proliferation capacity of the stem cells is high in dental pulp stem cells when compared to the umbilical cord.